Sometime last year, I created a video that showed how to create non-standard charts in Excel, so like info charts. Now, some people actually call them dome charts. If you missed that one, I'm going to put the link to it in the descriptions. Now, a few weeks ago, I got this question from one of my Udemy students. Diego asked, "Is there any way to create this chart in Excel?" So basically a chart that has symbols which are aligned on the right-hand side and a label on the left-hand side. What do you think? Can we set this up in Excel? Sure we can. Let's get to work. That's our simple data set. For female, I just input the 43% here. Male, I put a formula, 1 minus the female amount. Now let's just assume that's the percentage of female and male that buy our product. And we want to create an info chart on this. So let's just take a second look at the diagram that we have here. The 43% represents that blue box here. The one that's behind it, that's in light gray, is the full amount, which is the 100%. So we could set this one up first. Once we're done with it, we could replicate it and update the data source and also our symbol here. Okay, so let's get to work. Now let's also add the value for the full amount. So I'm going to call it full and put in 100% here. Let's create a bar chart based on this. So just highlight the data set, go to insert and insert a bar chart. Okay, just a normal clustered bar chart. We get them beside each other, but we don't want that. We need to switch things around. Right mouse click, go to select data, and switch the row and the column. Okay, so this gives us the female percentage right here, and that's our full percentage amount. So we're fine with this, but what we need to do is to overlap them. We need to bring this on top of this. So just click on any of this series, press Control 1, or you can also double click to activate the format options or right mouse click and format the data series. So where is the series overlap? Well, it's right here. It's on 0% now, but we're going to take it all the way up to 100%. And this way we get one of them overlapping the other. Now in this case, the wrong one has gone on top of the other one, right? So we need to change that order. I'm going to right mouse click, go to select data, and I'm going to push down the female because the last series that we added, that's the one that comes on top, but I don't want that one to be on top. So I'm going to click on this series and push it down. Okay, and that's fine. So now it looks good. One thing I'm going to do is to go back to series options. Okay, so click on one of these series. It doesn't matter which one. Go to series options and decrease the gap width to 0%. That's going to fill up our entire plot area with our series. Then let's just remove the title. Let's remove our axis. I'm just pressing the delete button on these. And let's fix our X axis to be between 0 and 100%. Okay, so go to axis options. For minimum, I'm actually going to fix it. Just put in a 0, press enter so that you see the reset button. That means you've really fixed it. The same thing for the maximum, 1, press enter, now we fix it. Okay, now let's make this smaller. And let's also remove the axis here. Okay, I'm just gonna go to format and remove the outline of my chart. Okay, so that looks better. Okay, now we have the rough shape correct, but it would look nicer to have that rounded edges instead of the sharp edges here. To get that look, let's go and insert a shape that has the shape that we like. So I'm going to click on that square with the rounded edges, just drag it here. Okay, so that's the shape that I want this one to have. And it's the same shape that I want the other one to have, but I just want it to be in a different color. So let me fix the color of my shape first. So under format, let's go to shape fill. I'm going to go with this blue. And for shape outline, I don't want an outline, so let's just do no outline. Okay, so that looks nice. Now, here is the important part. click on your shape, press Control C, okay, to copy, click on this series, press Control V, okay, and we get it in there. Now let's do the same for the full range. But first, we need to have the right color. So I'm going to copy this, I'm going to paste this, and I'm going to change the color to a light gray. Under Format, under Shape Fill, let's pick this gray. Okay, so again, Control C, click on the series, Control V. Okay, so this part is starting to look good. Now there is a tiny little line here and here. That seems to be the grid lines. Let's just remove them. Okay, great. So now what we need, let's go back to our image, is to add this label here. And then let's try and add the symbol to this. First, let's do the easy part, the label. For that, we can just activate the data label for this series. So just right mouse click, add labels. Now let's just push the label to the base. So click on the label first, go to options here, and for label position, let's select inside base. The rest is just formatting. We just need to make this quite big. I'm going to go with 20. And we can also choose a different font since this is an infographic. I'm going to go with Lato. It's right here, black. So Lato Black is a free font that you can download. I find it looks quite nice on PowerPoint and on infographics. So let's make this white as well. Okay, so now comes our symbol. First, just get a symbol of your choice. I'm going to use one of Microsoft's inbuilt symbols that are relatively new in Office 365. Under icons, you have a lot of different icons. And the icon that we need in this case is just right on top. I want this one and this one. So I'm going to click on them and insert them right here. Okay, so let's just bring them to the side. Now I'm just going to reduce their size to the size that I would like to have in the chart. So something like that. I want to make the second one identical to the first one. So let me just copy this, go to the second one and paste it in there. So by default, that should adjust. Yeah, both are the same. Now I'm going to make them in a light color. So for the graphics fill, let's go with a light gray just so that it stands out on top of the blue. Now let's just make this a little bit thinner too. Okay, that looks good. Now the aim is to put this graphic right here. The challenge is to put it in a dynamic way. So whenever this is getting more, this is moving with it and it always stays in the same place. How do we do that? Whenever it comes to manipulating charts, the answer is usually you need a new series and we need a new series for this. And basically the series is super simple. All we need the series to have is to plot one single point right here at the end. And that point, of course, has to be dynamic. So it has to somehow be related to this 43%. And we're going to use our symbol as our chart series. Okay, so let me show you what I mean. First, let's add our series. I'm going to just call it icon here. In the first round, let's just make this equal to this number. We can see later if we need to adjust it. So now we need to add this 43% in here as a dot. What chart type is that? A scatter plot, right? That gives us dots. But at this moment in time, Excel doesn't know that we want to add a dot, right? Anything we add to this, it's going to think we want to add a column chart. So let's add our column chart. I'm going to right mouse click, go to select data, click on add. The series name is icon and the series values, where right now I just have this 43%. Let's just click on this and say okay and okay. Now that's the last series that we added. So it's put it on top of our blue series. We want it to be a scatter plot. So the second thing I need to do is to change the series chart type. So right mouse click, change series chart type, And from here, for the icon series only, let's select a scatter plot. Okay, and right away, Excel plots it on this secondary axis. That's the only place it can plot it because this side is already been taken. So it needs to plot it on the other side. That's fine for us. We're going to go with OK. But now we can see that our dot is right here. It's too high. We want our dots to always sit in the middle here. The great thing is that we're working with a scatter plot. And the advantage of scatter plot series is that you can give it numbers for the x-axis as well as the y-axis. What's our y-axis number? It should be somewhere in the middle here. And our y-axis number is always going to be fixed because we always want our dot to be in the middle of our series here. So we can fix that by first fixing our secondary axis. So let's just activate it, go to options here. Under axis options, let's really fix the minimum to 0. So just put in a 0, press enter, and I'm going to fix the maximum to a 1, to 100%, and press enter. Okay, and this has moved here, but it's not exactly on the 50% line because right now it thinks it should plot it on 43%, right? That's the Y value we've given it. So let's go and change this data set. So I'm going to right mouse click anywhere on this chart, go back to select data. For my icon, now I get something in addition. I get series X values, which I didn't have before because now I'm working with a scatter plot. But check this out. My Y value is 43, but my Y value should actually be 50%, right? Because I want it to always sit in the middle. And the X value should actually be 43 because 43 is somewhere here. Remember, this goes from 0 to 100%. So 43 is going to sit right here, actually, right at the end of this bar. Okay, so let's switch things around. I'm going to just cut this one out. And for the Y value, I'm going to fix it to 0.5. So I'm just going to type it in 0.5. And for the X value, I'm going to paste what I had under Y, which is basically referencing this number here. Okay, and I'm going to say OK. And this symbol just shifted right there, right? So it sits about right. Let's just first remove this one that we don't see it. And second, let's replace this circle with our symbol. The same trick. Just click on your symbol, Control C, click on this series in the chart and Control V. Okay, now we have our symbol in there. The only thing is that it's sitting exactly on the end and we want to adjust it a little bit. So let's just update this formula by bringing it a little bit down. So I'm just going to bring it down by, let's say, 6%, and it puts it right here. Right? So depending on how big your symbol is, you just need to update this adjustment. Okay, so that looks pretty good. Let's just double check with our original. That was this. And our version is this. Let's just make sure that this is dynamic. So I'm going to change this to 67. Everything updates. Let's even go to 100%. Looks good. Let's go to 28%. Looks good. Now we can replicate this for male. We just have to add this part in. And then we can copy and paste our graph here and update the series. The only thing is when you use shapes in charts and you change the original series to something else, it resets your shapes. So you just have to copy and paste these in there again. Okay, so if I just click on this, I'm going to drag this for male and update this as well. Okay, you see that it got reset here. So we just have to copy and paste these shapes in there again. You can also right mouse click, go to select data, and do the update here. So for the icon, I'm just going to click on this, go to edit. The title is fine. The X value should be down here. So I need to make a calculation here. Let's just delete that, replace it with this. And the Y value, that stays the same. That's going to be fixed. So let's go with OK. That's that. And let's just copy this formula and paste it here. So the relative referencing works to our advantage here. Now all we have to do is Control C, Control V, and that's that. And let's change our symbol. And let's add the data label. Now there is a quick way to copy and paste formatting for data labels. Just click on this data label, do Control Shift C, so not Control C, but Control Shift C, click on this one and do Control Shift V. And this way we paste the formatting. Okay, so now let's just do some testing here. So that's how you can create info charts that incorporate symbols in this way. And you don't have to just work with the male and female symbol. You can also add in your products. Let's say you sell office supplies and phones. You could put a symbol of the product that you're selling in there and create this nice visualization. If you like this video, I'd appreciate it if you gave it a thumbs up. And while you're here, why not subscribe to this channel if you're interested in the topics that you see on the channel? This way you're going to get updates when new videos come out.